Carolee, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Oh, good morning, Bill. Thank you, Bill. I commend your comments about the majority of parents neither need nor want surrogate parenting and instead seek positive moral support versus morally neutral from those who influence their children, particularly in the classroom. And that's key about the story coming out of Cumberland County. And thank you, Tony, for being involved with your children. You know, I'll add, not with my child, you know, you don't. Parents, be aware, be involved. This is yet another event about an inappropriate school assignment, and this is key. Given without parental consent, without prior knowledge, and without opportunity to opt out until after it was assigned. And this time, in an English language arts class, not family life or a health or sex ed class, where parents are allowed to opt out in New Jersey. So that this, this morning I wrote to Commissioner Hespe, the New Jersey Department of Education, and President Mark Biedron of the New Jersey State Board of Education, telling them they have to distance themselves from such assignments without parental knowledge. These 13-year-olds were asked to write a reactive response to the scenario that you described in the assignment, which is supposed to be connected to Sean Covey's best-selling book, The Seven Habits of Highly Effective Teens. Interestingly enough, Sean Covey comes from a very devout Mormon family. It doesn't come from his book. It's a supplemental assignment. He would be astounded and ashamed that his good book was being abused like this without parental consent. We have a law in New Jersey already that says with student surveys, it's from the year 2000, and we have fought to maintain the language of this law over the last 15 years because it comes under attack to diminish it, whereby no student is to be given a student survey about behavior, including sex and drug and alcohol abuse, without prior written informed parental consent.
Now, wait a minute. Now, Carolee, just so our audience understands that is already the law in New Jersey?
Yes. Yeah, sure. It's the law. It's, in 2001.
So it's required? Prior consent of a parent is required before behavioral conversations are had?
Not conversations, but surveys,
right.
And that still happens in New Jersey despite the law, and then the parent has the right to sue or the district suffers a fine for it. But if that pertains to what they've done now and whether this is cluelessness, mindlessness, carelessness, or intentional, they slip these types of conversations into other subject matter where it doesn't belong. And it's not right. And I don't know if, the superintendents will apologize thereafter, but we have to be more proactive in saying, no, whether or not we use the various educrats in the state to stop it and or change teacher education, but teachers have to recognize and respect the right of a parent to know about these very, very sensitive subject matter. And yes, there is a great social change in our society today, and that's why, I even have a Boy Scout merit badge called Family Life, where it's insisted the child develop a meeting with their parents to discuss these sensitive topics.
Right.
But it comes out of
Carolee, can I ask you to hang on the line for a minute? I have another question for you. I want to just talk about that, the changes in society and how it impacts people, and that, that ability to parent in these very treacherous waters out there of almost no standards. But here's my question. So Carolee, you're the head of a group called Eagle Forum in New Jersey, and you've been a parental advocate for parents' rights going back as long as I have known you. And, I looked up during the break, I looked up that law that you were talking about that the acting governor, I guess this was Don DeFrancesco, right, back in 2002 in January, signed the New Jersey Protection of Pupil Rights, the New Jersey Student Survey Bill, right? These were the bills that essentially said that parents have the right to object and be informed before conversations about behavior, risky behavior, were taking place in the schools.
Well, this is about surveys in particular, and that emanated out of Ridgewood, New Jersey, in Bergen County, 175 very nosy, intrusive survey. And this... and it concerns all kinds of sensitive topics, but what it does is it recognizes that parenting is such a great privilege, but with that privilege comes responsibilities and challenges, and children shouldn't be having children, so parents should be involved. So it allows the parent to be involved, to look at the surveys and to say yay or nay that my child can or cannot have it. And if the parent doesn't sign off on that permission slip. The survey is not given. It's not just, you know, I didn't get the notification home.
And they can opt out, right? They can opt out of that. And they can opt out of sexual education. Is that right?
Not even, yes. And definitely, you see, this is the key with this particular subject out of the school in Cumberland County, is that the parents didn't know it was part of an English language arts class. Today, because of Common Core and cross-disciplinary practices, 70% of English language arts is about information, not about literature. So they stick this subject or this assignment into English language arts where parents don't expect it. They expect perhaps this topic to emerge in family life or health ed or sex ed, where by New Jersey practice, parents can opt their children out, but they didn't expect this in English language arts. So once again, this is wrong. Keep it, if you must discuss this field, it should be in family life. The parents should have the right to review the curriculum and say yay or nay with their child. I mean, I've heard of lots of things going on in these classes that I personally wouldn't approve of, and a lot of other parents would. And give the parent the right to opt out if they want to.
There you go.
To be notified about that. It's a parental right. And that's the key to all of this. And use English language arts for literature and keep these topics to
teaching English. Exactly. All right. Carolee Adams, thank you very much for joining me. I always appreciate your perspective. And I agree with you. This is about parental rights. This is not about the value of what we need to be teaching kids at 13. I could argue that as well. But thanks, Carolee. Appreciate your perspective.